Good morning, everybody. I am Elliot from My Online Car Guy 1. You are here at the Defiant Audio Shop in Delaware, and today we are going to be doing a Lambo door conversion, or a vertical door conversion, on this 2021 Camaro.
Welcome home,
sir. Cue the intro. So we're gonna get into it. We're gonna go fast, high speed, because there's a lot of work to be done. I'm gonna try to cram this into a little itty bitty video. Vertical Doors Inc. See if I can get you a logo. There you go. Vertical Doors Inc. Get you a kit. I'm gonna go install this on this Camaro. To go inside of that fender there, which means that those hinges that are already in the fender, those need to come out. The simplest way to do this is not to take the door off, okay? Everybody always thinks you take the door off. I will do this entire install, and this door is not gonna come off this Camaro not one time, and you'll see. So in order for me to get to these hinges, I have to take apart the entire front clip. Really, what I really need is just to take the fenders off. But by design, this fender here has mounting points that go into the front clip all the way through this connection point on both sides, along with some more stuff up here up top. So for me, the simplest way to approach this one is gonna be to pull this entire front clip off, front end, front fenders, pull it all off, and what that's gonna do is expose the OEM or the factory hinges. So I'm gonna do that right now. We're gonna get that all opened up. We'll do high speed, fast speed, whatever. Editor's gonna smack you in the face with a commercial real quick, and then we will dive into that. Hey everybody, I just wanted to say thank you for watching the videos. We go through a lot of trouble to put these together. I know it's a lot of information, and they're long. Some of these videos are pretty long. But I want you to know you are genuinely appreciated by myself, the rest of the guys here at the shop for watching the videos. We read all the comments. You guys are the best. If you haven't already, click subscribe somewhere at the bottom. That way you get free notification every time we post the new videos. And drop us a line, shoot us a message, ask your questions. We answer. Look below, you'll see. We answer. Okay? Thank you. Bye. Depot on the beat. Okay, so we got the fender off, but for the most part, this is the goal, is we want to get the fender here pulled off so that we can see right here where the factory hinges are, so we can get in there and make the swap. So another part that does need to come off of the door before you're able to swap the hinges and all out, pretty much right before or right after you get the fender off, this little bit is called a door check. The door check is this little bar here inside of the door that keeps your factory door from opening any more than normal. It's also the part that gives that little like bumper. So when you open your door, it has that spot where it just kind of stops itself. That's what that is. So it's super important to get that off before you start taping your door into place. Because once you tape your door into place, then you're not gonna be able to get to it anymore. So don't forget to remove your bump stop. So it looks like the bolt here, the lighter silver bolts here on the door frame are 10 millimeter bolts. And the bolts on the body side here are 13. So we're gonna have a 13 millimeter socket with a short head is what I'll be using there. That guy with a long handle, so I have some leverage because this thing's gonna be in there pretty tight. And then I will be using a 10 on a longer extension so that I can just reach up in there like so. But before I do that, the vertical door's hinge itself has to be adjusted. When they come, they're semi-modular, so the shock is not installed yet. The adjustment points are not set yet. That easiest to do here on a table rather than under the load of a car. So there are multiple points on this that I'm gonna explain what each one of these does. Particularly, there are four key points. We have this little Allen bolt here in the center with a lock nut. And what this does is it manages the door down, okay? So when I tighten this bolt up here, this thread will stick out a little further, which would make it so that when the door is in the down position, when it comes down, it stops sooner or it stops later. If I extend it so the thread is sticking out, then this will be the end of the door closure. Where it is right now is saying that this is the end of the door closure. So I'll need to adjust that part particularly once it's on the car. But for now, so that the metal here isn't touching, I'm gonna go ahead and thread this in a little further, and we're gonna start with a reference point about there. Now, that brings us to this guy here. This little Allen bolt here is for the head of the shock. Now, when you order your kits from Vertical Doors Inc., they will supply a shock. There's a big old long old part number here, which is scaled to the weight of your door. So if you have modifications in your door, additional speakers, amps, or anything like that, that would change the weight of the door, then the shock that they're gonna send you by default is not gonna work. So just something to think about. So I need to unthread this bolt to put the shock in there. And also, we have this other part here. This is the sleeve, the lock sleeve down here at the bottom where the shock's gonna go into. So let's open this up like so, and this will go in. This part will slide through, and you see that little hole right there on it? Goes all the way through. When it goes through here, we will use the supplied lock pin that they gave us. It'll run right through there, and it'll keep the shock from sliding out of that position. So the first thing I want to do is get the shock in. So we will be using this bolt. We'll be using that lock pin, and we'll get the shock in. And that'll address that bolt and that sleeve. This adjustment here, I already told you, I'm gonna set that a little bit further out from where it is so that the metal's not touching, but this will need to be adjusted once I have the kit on the car, of course, because it pivots here up and down as its stop point, which will adjust how well it matches to the door latch. And then finally, there's this little pin here, this Allen bolt. And what this one does is when the door swings outward, like this, that little bolt defines the stopping point there. So if I thread that in a little further, then when you go to open the door, it would stop here. In this case, it's backed out, so now it's gonna stop here. What that means, in case you're not sure really what I'm talking about here, is you guys have all seen the doors have kind of a two-step motion where if you're looking at the door, you are opening it out and then up. Well, with Vertical Doors Inc., they gave you this kind of like this little bunny like bumper ear to make sure that if you're not out enough, it won't clear. What we want is to come out just over that bumper there, but we don't want extra slack beyond that. See how like we're over the bumper? And right now I have all of this. That means that your door is gonna flail around this much. So what I need to do is kind of rest this on that bumper, tighten this bolt down so that there's no extra play there, so that when the door's opened, it'll open and it kind of has a channel where it has tension from the bumper and from the adjustment bolt there. I'm gonna go ahead and make the assembly here for this, and then we're gonna go over to this side and get the hinge on so I can show you. So let's go. The vertical door assembly assembled and adjusted. I'm getting ready to undo the bolts for the door, but first we're gonna go to the tape. I'm not gonna take this door off. Instead, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna tape this door with the window, and I'm gonna tape this whole edge up. Does this sound crazy? But I'm gonna tape this whole edge up, then I'm gonna take the hinges off. So this whole door is only gonna be held onto this car by the latch in the back and tape. So that's the next step. Tape the whole door all up, undo the brackets, throw on the new bracket, adjust the new bracket to match the door, not the door to match the bracket. And I know this is redundant, but it is unbelievably important. When I do that, first time out the box, this door will go up, come down, latch, no problemo. So let's go ahead and do this in fast motion. Okay, so this is one of the door seams, right? And you can see how smooth the tape is between the door and the body, like how, like that's straight. But like you see that little bit of wrinkle right there? This one's not that big a deal because I haven't fully taken everything off yet. But as I release the bracket, I need to pay very close attention to how the tape moves within that seam and that gap. Because if the door shifts, it goes like this, the tape up top will show a stress wrinkle and the tape along the bottom here will show a stress wrinkle. So as I release these bolts, it's very important to pay extremely close attention to that because that will tell you what's happening on like a millimeters level, like a microscopic level. That matters. That matters because if this door is gonna fall off, it will give you a warning by telling you through the tape before anything else. So let's go ahead and continue taking the rest of these off.
Few moments later.
So as you can see, right now, I have the hinge is still kind of set in there. It's just stuck with a little bit of dirt, maybe some, you know, for some of the fresh paint. But there's no bolts at all. Tape is on there and a nice hot mess. But the tension points are still straight. See, there's no wrinkle in that, which means that the door has not shifted at all. That's a great sign. So without too much more delay, let's get that kit bolted up in there. I want you to make note that when I put the shock on, I only put the head up top. I didn't put the bottom in yet. When I finish putting the bolts on, we're gonna lift the door and then set the shock in the seat and then set the door back on it so it all sits in together. And you'll see that when it comes time. But for now, it's important that only the top part of the shock here be mounted and not the bottom just yet. Otherwise, I'll be trying to fight the door hinge that's trying to push open, and we don't want that right now. Also, when I bolted this on, I bolted it on first with the body bolts. So I have the two longer bolts of the kit here in the body bolts that put the kit on the frame, like the body side of the car. Then I'm gonna use the shorter bolts to get in here for these holes. And there's two here, and there's two down below, down here. Hopefully you guys are following along and I didn't lose anybody along the way. Even if you're not working on a Camaro, this process is very, very like typical for most. There's a little couple of differences here, a couple of differences there from one car to another. But for the most part, this is how you do it. So we're just gonna continue. So, you know, if you're just trying to figure out how to do your kit, this is a really good foundation for you. Yours may be a little bit different if it's a different car, but for the most part, this is it. So we're gonna go ahead and get back to it. I'm gonna get these bolts in the door and we should be able to lift this door up here in the next couple of minutes. Okay, so all the mounting points are mounted in place. That doesn't mean this door is any more stable because remember, I got the shock completely loose right now. But you can see all the mounting bolts are all in place. They're good and tight. And I still have yet to take the door off of the car. So the next thing that I need to do is adjust this tensioner when we get it open. Right now, I want to adjust this one. This nut that's on top of it is to keep the Allen bolt from working itself loose every time the door goes up and down. Because when the door comes down, that is the bump stop, is that Allen bolt. Right now that's on and it's touching. I'm gonna put like a quarter turn more so that I have tension on there. And honestly, once I do that, then I'll have one of these two come lift the door up. I'll line the shock up to this hole. And when they set the door down, it'll just slide right in. I'll smack the cotter pin in. And as far as the mechanical portion, that would have us completed. Everything else ends up reassembly and that wire harness, which we'll go over that as well. Okay, so it looks like all the vertical up and down settings are adjusted on the kit properly. The kit is on the car, is on the door and the body side. The next step is gonna be to go ahead and cut this tape off and manually lift the door so I can line the shock and drop it into place, knock the pin in, and we should have a functioning door. So let's give that a go. Okay, so right now, we have the door up. Coonley lifted it up so that the shock would stand up and the head would go far enough when it was dangling like this to come up. And then he lowered it and it seated. We've gone ahead and smacked in the little lock pin there. So everything is how it is. This is a vertical Lambo door, 2021 Camaro for your viewing pleasure. Next, we will have to address electrical boot and get that either back in here or relocate it. But for the most part, alignment should be flawless. And just remember, this is the first time that we've had to open this door to get this entire kit on, short of the disassembly. But you'll see how the door panel itself just clears the A-pillar. See that? It just clears the A-pillar. So now the door will come down. You see that? Little bump stop there. That bump that stopped it is this bolt right here. So the next thing to check, or to double check, is going to be our alignment, that this latch lines up to this spot here. Oh, it's off. That means what I need to do is come over here, tighten that up. Now watch this. We're going to do this real quick. So I'm going to take my wrench over there, and I'm going to tweak it just a little bit. So that brings us down. See that? What I'm going to do is unlock the lock nut here. All right. And right there is how we go up. There you go. See that? The way that just seated in there like that. It's still a hair low. Go like a quarter turn more. It's perfect. See that? And that adjustment, you can see this one here, it goes in on the side. So that bolt, when I thread it in, takes the back end of the door and raises it up. Okay, so as far as the vertical door install, that is really kind of the meat and the potatoes of how that goes. I've done many and many of these installs. They pretty much install the same. It's pretty cut and dry. You have to pull the fenders off, leave the doors on, take the door check off, or bump stop, or whatever it is that you want to call that, that little piece inside in between the hinges that stops the door from swinging all the way around into the front fender. Gotta take that, the door check out, tape the door into place, remove the hinges, the factory hinges, and disconnect or move your harness, your door boot out of the way. Bolt in the new kit after trying to preset your settings and such on there. Bolt it all on and then put that on the car, leaving the shock dangling, right? Only the top bolt. Have somebody lift that door up so that the bottom of the shock lines up. Put it in the plunger in its little spot where it's got to go. And then put in the lock pin for that. Once that lock pin is in, then you're pretty much good to go. There's a couple of tricks and tips for the harness. I guess I'll leave you guys with that information real quick. This harness by itself is too short. Very clearly, that's not going to reach. Plus, in this case, which is very typical of most, when the door arm here is in place, you can see the connector, the factory connector on the body side, is behind the arm. So that is also not going to work. So what I am going to do is use this bracket that came with the vertical doors kit here. I'm going to cut one wire at a time and extend this harness, and then use this plate here to run my wires into the body of the car this way. So that is it for today. Hopefully that gave you guys all the information you need. If you want to use a great kit, Vertical Doors Inc. over in California, they make a great kit. That's what we're using. They're not sponsors of this video whatsoever. They're just a good company that we've done many kits on. Actually, as a matter of fact, we're doing one here with their kit. This Camaro right here also has their kit on it. This Chrysler 300 has their kit on it. That 350Z has their kit on it. That's a whole lot of Lambo doors that have their kit on it. See that? That's another one we did quite some time ago. The car's here for some updates, but there's their vertical door kit right there. Nice and easy. See that? Great company. Obviously, we use them all the time. That's who we used here today. Hopefully, this video helps you guys out. If you guys are not already subscribers to the channel, now is that time to hit the bell, hit the subscribe, hit the like button, hit all kind of buttons down below, and hook a brother up. Okay? I'm out. Bye. For day two, now that the mechanic work has been completed here with the Lambo door kit, next is the electrical work.